to about 16 or 17 as we travel further south. Charlie and Naga.
Carol, thanks so much. Carol, I wonder if you want to join in the conversation we've just been having with Mark Almond on the sofa. Charlie and Mark have been having. Do you want to tell us, Mark?
Well, we were talking about travel passes, actually, that we're both eligible for the older person's travel pass.
Didn't know about it, Carol.
That's absolutely fantastic.
I don't think Carol is eligible yet.
Not yet.
Charlie
not
was just saying he's just going to get his. Surely. It's fantastic, Charlie.
Yeah. Is it good? Do you travel anywhere?
It's really good.
In London.
On the tube, on the bus, on the train.
There you go.
Yeah. I'll be updated when you're 65 as well, so I'm due for an updated one.
There you go. I mean, those are the kind of things we talk about. Well, Carol will always let you know what the weather's like, so if you do need to get a bus or the tube, won't you, Carol?
Absolutely, with pleasure.
On that thing, thank you, Carol. On that thing, Mike. So, if you do, I don't know if do you travel on the bus and the tube
I actually do. Yeah, one of the great things about the masks thing is I can go anywhere and do anything and wear the mask.
Well, I was going to say, do people recognise you if you're?
I do get recognised. Do you? All the time, but right. I find I usually carry around with a baseball cap and the masks were fantastic, so nobody recognised.
And what's the convention? Do people sing one of your songs to you? How does that normally play out?
Usually very, very nice, actually, and they come up and everybody likes Tainted Love, so they always say that or say hello, wave goodbye, and so people are actually really, really nice. I've never had anybody come up and be nasty.
No, that's great. Do they do their say hello?
Well, cab drivers, in other words, cab drivers, speak to my missus, she's just on the end of the phone. Can you sing a bit down the phone? So you're going to go, oh, blah, so I do sometimes, yeah. It's just easier that way, Charlie, because if you argue about it or say, no, I'm not doing it, I'm not doing that, it's just more stressful. So it's best to say, do it, I think.
And people love it, don't they? Yeah. I mean, for anyone who doesn't know what we're talking about, how could you not, soft sell, how would you not know? But we'll give you a little trip down memory lane, first of all. Right up to the future, because that's the new song with the Pet Shop Boys. How did that come about?
Well, it was kind of an amazing surprise, actually, Naga, because I never expected it to happen. Neil and Chris came to see us do some shows before Christmas, and Pet Shop Boys have always said they've really found some inspiration in Soft Cell from our Non-Stop Erotic Cabaret album, and we were performing the whole of that album before Christmas, and we did a few new songs as well. We did this song, Purple Zone. And Neil and Chris went away and said, we love that song, Purple Zone. And I didn't know they were going to do this, because I was actually on holiday, and my manager came to me and said, what do you think of this? And he played it me, and it was like, what's this Purple Zone, isn't it? But it sounds like it's been remixed. It sounds a bit Pet Shop Boys. And then Neil's voice came in singing. And I actually felt very touched and very moved, actually. I was quite emotional about that, because I thought, yes, finally, Soft Cell and Pet Shop Boys have come together to do a collaboration and a duet.
It would have been the stuff of dreams. It would have been the stuff of dreams back in the day.
Yeah, it was a pop moment, a lovely pop moment where we'd kind of, because we both had this kind of heritage together and everything, and we've finally come together to make a record, and it was just a lovely, lovely thing, and it's kind of set fire, really, and people love it, and it's a moment.
Is there anyone else on the list, collaborations that you've always thought, there's a thing there that we could do something with?
I think the thing about collaborations is if you plan them too much, they kind of fall through and they never happen. And the best collaborations that happen are the ones that just happen so quickly and you never expect it. And I never expected this. It was a complete lovely surprise to me. And Neil and Chris are lovely. We did a video together. I've never had much of a chance to really talk to them over the years properly. We went out for dinner together and found we had lots to talk about in common. So I just absolutely love them, and I think they're great for them
doing this. I bet over the years you must have, you were saying about those songs, they're kind of really iconic songs. You must have met lots of people, famous people as well, who when they first met you, go, do you know what, I love that song.
Yeah, it's nice. I mean, I'm always very starstruck by people, actually. I'm still very shy of meeting stars and things. So people come up to me and they say, oh, I love that song, I love what you do and everything. I'm always quite shy about it, actually.
Like who?
Don't put me on the spot, Charlie. I can't think. But, you know, people just generally who you meet in the music. I never meet a lot of my heroes. Because I've always avoided trying to meet a lot of my heroes because I like to be a fan, you know, and somebody who still
don't want to be disappointed,
buys records and loves records. So I was always happy that I never really met David Bowie properly. I never really met people that I kind of really admired and liked. I can still be a fan. I hope they can still be a fan of mine too, but I haven't disappointed them.
It's a good approach.
How did you feel, because during lockdown, Tainted Love kind of went viral, crazy on TikTok.
It went absolutely. Well, I didn't really know what TikTok was. I know that sounds awful.
No,
but
I'm still not.
Everyone says, "Oh, it's gone mad on TikTok," and I'm thinking, "What's great? That's fantastic. What's TikTok? You know, it's great. It's brilliant." But I'm kind of glad. But I mean, the whole lockdown period was a strange period because I wrote the whole album through lockdown and recorded all my vocals for the new album through lockdown. So it really was a strange time that really reflected on a lot of the themes of this album. I mean, it's a weird situation now because I'm actually living 2 years ago because everything has been rescheduled so much. The album was delayed, my tour, solo tour. I've got my solo tour was cancelled 3 times because of everything, and it's now happening in October now because I had COVID last time and it had to cancel it. So I'm still living 2 years ago and doing solo things when I should be doing soft sell things and vice versa.
I suppose in a way the TikTok thing, apart from anything else, it will maybe drawn a new audience to some of your stuff.
I think it did, and I think, you know, I'm always curious about these things. It's always lovely when these things happen. I'm never a crazy social media person, really. I stay away from Twitter, which is the best thing.
Did you ever do that?
I'd stay away from it. I don't even know my password now. I have
not a bad thing.
It's got a new record out, that's it. You know, when I did it myself, I just thought, it's probably not a very good thing, really. But I love my Instagram. My Instagram is my personal diary, which I do myself, and I really like it.
It's seen as the happiest social media, isn't it? Yeah. Can you put something to rest? So there was a debate this morning. How do you say your name?
Mark Almond. 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 Not almond.
What about almond?
Almond.
What about almond?
I've always said
you can't
almond.
Say your own name.
So you sort of say the L, but not almond or almond. Almond.
Is that clear, Charlie? It's no clear.
What a debate.
I said almond, Mark
yeah,
almond.
Yeah, you're right, yeah.
He's Charlie said Mark almond.
No, what I said was, no, I fudged it because I said Mark almond.
No, you didn't.
I think Naga wins, actually.
We can finish it there.
Almond. That would be...
It's your name. Whatever you say goes, okay? I can't believe it. It's your name.
Folks, I've got a new record out. I've got a new album out. Happiness Not Included out on the 6th. We're talking about... We're meant to be talking about my new record.
We did.
Okay, new album out, Happiness Not Included, out on the 6th. My solo tour will be on my website. All the new dates for October.
There you go.
We can go back to talking about almonds.
It just makes me hungry.
You'll make a lot of people very happy with the new stuff.
Thank you.
Enjoy it.
I've been here so many times now that I kind of feel at home, that I'm sitting on the sofa.
And
what I always love is the lighting is always fantastic.
Oh, there you go.
It's great.
But it is on that side.
But you look beautiful anyway.
Thank you. You're pretty good looking yourself.
So you know.
We'll carry on with the love fest. Give us a moment. Headlines are coming up.
Stitch in the ditch, waistband rip, can only mean one thing. The Great British Sewing Bee is back with a new host, me, Sarah Pascoe.